Daddy God, you're perfect in all of your ways to us. There you go, Daddy, you're perfect in all of your ways. Perfect in all of your ways. Daddy God, you're perfect in all of your ways to us. And one day I'm in my living room and this spontaneous song comes out of me after singing that. Daddy God, you're so perfect, you're so perfect, you're so more perfect than I even get. You're way, way, way perfect, Jesus, Daddy God. And I just started singing, you're so good, you never change your mind. Sing that with me. You never change your mind. What a promise. Change your mind. 'Cause you alone are God. You are the only one I need. I bow all of me at your feet. I worship you alone. 'Cause you and watching over everything I see and do to perform it on. place my universe in the hands of the Lord. I place the universe of my emotions in your hands. The universe of my struggles in your hands. I place it all inside Daddy's hands. Daddy's hands. Place it all inside my Daddy's hands. Blessed be the name of the Lord. 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 Blessed be the name of the Lord.
We're in your hands. You hold me close. Let your love surround me. Draw me near. Bring me to your side. Oh, and
yeah.
us up where we belong. Where the eagles fly.
Wow. Eagles fly.
Come fly, come fly, come fly, eagles. Come fly, come fly.
Oh, prophetic voice of Orange County.
To new levels, new places in the heavenly realm. New places in the heavenly realm. God, as we go into the baptism, Lord, let us continue to just fly. Thank you, Jesus. Our old life is buried, and our new life is flying this morning. So we're releasing the prophetic and releasing the spirit right now in this church, in this season, for such a time as this. You have brought us to this place of prosperity. And we declare it is prosperity you brought us into in this moment. We receive you. We receive you, Jesus. You are our prosperity, Daddy God.
Amen. Amen. Wow. Thank you, Aeron. Well, good morning. We're glad you're here. It's kind of going to be a fun day.
Yeah.
We celebrate today Thanksgiving.
Come on.
Those of you that are going to be baptized and the baptizers, go ahead and go that way and get ready. This morning, we're going to baptize some people. There's nothing to cheer about more than that. Listen, you know what Jesus, just before he rose, he asked his disciples, he said, listen, I want you to go into all the world. I want you to teach people about me and everything that I've done. And he says, and I want you to baptize them. So this morning, we're going to join with some people as they're baptized. And you're going to find that Jesus didn't say, go to your pastor and have them baptize you. He says, when you make disciples, baptize them. And so each person who's being baptized this morning has chosen a person in their life that they found was instrumental in their faith, and that person gets the honor of baptizing them. Amen? Isn't that cool? In Acts 2:38, after Peter had given the sermon on Pentecost Sunday, it says that the people's hearts were torn. They said, what do we do? And he said this, he says, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus, for the forgiveness of your sin. And then he gave us a promise, and he said, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. In Romans, Paul describes baptism. He says, do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, in him by baptism into death, in order that just as Jesus Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. Baptism symbolizes a death to self. It's saying, I realize that in my own effort, I have nothing. And so when you go under the water, it symbolizes being dead, being killed. Myself is being killed, just as Jesus died on the cross. And then Jesus rose from the dead. He rose that we would have life. And so then as we rise, it says that we rise in Him, in the power of His might. Peter said, He has given us all that we need for life and godliness in Christ Jesus. And so as we rise out of the baptism water, we find that we've empowered to live the life that Christ has really given us to live. His Holy Spirit actually lives inside us. So, the first person going to be baptized this morning is Jude. Yeah! Says the reason he decided to be baptized today is he really does want to follow Jesus. He says, my mom helped me learn more about God by teaching me all the great things that he did. And he's asked his mom to baptize him because she is his biggest supporter.
Come on.
Isn't that cool? Woo-hoo. Awesome. So Jude, have you given your life to Jesus?
Yes.
Have you decided that you're going to follow Him for the rest of your life?
Yes.
What name would you like to be baptized by?
Judah.
Go ahead, Mom. There you go. Perfect.
Wow, wow, wow.
Jude Adams, I baptize you in the name of the amazing Father, the warrior Son Jesus, and the incredible Holy Spirit.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Is Rebecca G. Bennett. Rebecca actually accepted the Lord 2 years old. She's being baptized, she says, because the Bible says to. She says, my mom helped me learn more about God by reading the Bible to me, and I've asked my dad to baptize me because I wanted him to.
That's awesome.
Yeah!
So Rebecca, have you accepted Jesus into your life?
Yes.
Do you want to follow Him for the rest of your life?
Yes.
What name would you like to be baptized by?
Rebecca Bennett.
I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Accepted Jesus when she was around 2 years old. She says, Jesus wants me to get baptized, and that's why she's doing it. And she says her parents helped her learn more about Jesus.
Woo!
Talking about Him on car rides and going to church.
Come on.
She's asked both her mom and dad to baptize her.
Nice.
Because Pastor Don said that was okay.
Yeah.
All right. Holy faith. Have you decided to ask Jesus into your life? Would you like to follow him for the rest of your life?
Yes.
What name would you like your mom and dad to baptize you by? Felicity Joy.
Well, well.
And I asked her, why have you decided to be baptized? She says, because it was in my heart to be baptized. She asked her mom and her dad, and she learned about God by reading the Bible, praying, having them read the Bible to her, pray with her, and talk with her about Jesus. So she's asked her mom and dad to baptize her, because she says, I trust them most. And they led me to Jesus. So Felicity, have you decided to give your life to Jesus as Lord and Savior? Would you like to follow him for the rest of your life? What name would you like your mom and dad to baptize you by? All right.
Come on.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we baptize.
Baptized as Kahana Chor. Awesome. I asked her when she decided to ask Jesus in her life, and she said, when I was 4 years old, and to be baptized today because I want to be closer to God. My mom and dad helped me learn about God by telling me stories in the Bible. And I've asked my dad to baptize me because I love him. Kahana, have you given your life to Jesus?
Yes.
You want to follow him all the rest of your days?
Yeah.
What name would you like to be baptized by?
Kahana.
Come on.
That's it, perfect.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you.
Baptized today is Ashley Balu. She decided to follow Jesus and give her life to him on July 16, 2013. She says, I decided that I no longer want to live for my wants, but rather live for Jesus and through him. My grandparents helped me learn more about God by continuously providing me with knowledge and wisdom of Christ. No matter how silly my questions would be, they gave me a safe place to learn about him. And I've asked my grandfather Ed to baptize me because he has always been there for me. He believes in my dreams and aspirations. He is a very important role model in my life, and I wouldn't have it any other way. Ashley, so you've given your life to Jesus?
Yes.
You want to follow him the rest of your days?
Thank you.
What name would you like your grandpa to baptize you by?
Ashley Balloon. Ashley Balloon, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
For the Lord God Almighty. In a few minutes, we're going to take our offering for the poor, for the needy. The Bible says that he who is kind to the poor lends to his maker. And we're going to do it different this year than we have in the past. We're taking one offering, our entire offering, and sowing it into this ministry, the benevolence ministry. Normally we take one, kind of cover our bills and all that stuff, and then we take another one. But we've decided that we're going to take it all. We're going to give it all to the poor, to the needy, and do it so in faith, because we're poor and needy. And so we want to sow this entire offering into that. But before we do, I want to share a little bit. I've been gone. You probably didn't notice.
Yes, we did.
But I did. And I went to great churches. I had great situations I was ministering in. And I loved it. And the people are really kind. They're nice to me.
That's good.
They don't have to be around me all the time. But, you know, I choose you.
Yay. Thank you.
No.
Thank you.
I get to talk about you. And I really do appreciate you and your faithfulness to the Lord and to his service. There's face after face after face that comes to mind, and there are just so many people here. There are disciples, devoted followers of Jesus, men and women that don't have to be motivated, don't have to be entertained, don't have to have their, you know, their appetites satisfied by other stuff. We don't serve much here. We just serve Jesus. Just serve, you know, we open things up for the Holy Spirit. We want to love each other, love God, and love the world. It's that simple. So we don't put a lot into anything else, except for trying to put it into you. And it's a great privilege and a great honor. One of the things that I am known for when I'm out there ministering stuff is my honesty and vulnerability, and to me, it's a gift to people. It's a gift to people because it allows them to hurt. It allows them to say "ouch" when they're in pain. And there's just, in my opinion, too much rhetoric in the church about just looking over past your pain, not being allowed to feel your pain and struggle in life, because we do struggle in life. I mean, the Lord makes a big difference, obviously. I mean, the Lord is with us on the mountaintop, and that's awesome. But you know what's even better? He's with us in the valleys, in the dark times, in the pain. I can't look at you because I know your stories, and I know the pain that you go through in your life. And the fact that Jesus is there and he comforts you, because that's what he does. We didn't come to Jesus so that our life would improve. It's not a self-improvement program. It's an eternity improvement program. It changes the outcome of your eternity.
Yeah.
And that's what we need to keep our eyes focused on, is not this, but right over the head of that is him. Right over the head of all our problems, all our troubles, are the host of heaven. They're to serve us. They're to minister to us. I suffer from depression. I've covered up mask as well as I can. Don probably feels it more than anybody else, because it's accompanied by grumpiness.
Never.
Yeah, exactly. But it's just something I have. It's something I deal with all the time. And I actually deal with more after a trip like this, where I've been ministering every day for a couple weeks. I suffer from PMS, post-ministry syndrome, it's pretty much a normal thing. And you know, in that I feel isolated, I feel lonely, I feel like shutting down And so yesterday afternoon, you know, I was feeling all those things. And I thought, you know, I need to do something about this. And so I just went for a walk around my city and looked for people to be kind to.
Come on.
Look to people that to give to just say hello to be nice to them, to invest in them. You know, so I gave to some people and I talked to some people and I kind of gave my way out of depression, gave my way out of the pain. You know, we turn all these things into methods, and we write books about them, sell CDs. But you know, we're a living organism, and we have to do life as we go. And we can have ideas and principles and all that we work with, but we have to live every day in the present. And so this idea of giving to the poor, you know, is one that we're investing in ourselves. We're lending to our Maker. And He'll take care of us. And He'll take care of our needs. And so I think Paul commended the church in Thessalonica because they gave out of the abundance of their poverty. Whatever they had, they just gave. And they trusted the Lord with it. So when we give, I just want us to give in faith. I want us to give unto the Lord. I want us to give, you know, generously and without holding back, and just trusting God with it. And I think last year when this happened, we had a great offering, and it was a really key moment in this church's life. We've been through a lot of difficulty. There have been a lot of people saying the ship's going down. And that next week when we counted the offering, it was greater than the year before. And there was something released in the church. And there's a steadiness in this church and a consistency in the people that I think are being strengthened by the Lord as we go through the difficulties and the trials and tribulations that we do. And I know that you do. I know you do. I know you come in here smiling and cheerful and shaking hands and all that. But I know you. I know you. Some of you suffer from depression. Some of you feel isolated and lonely. Some of you struggle financially. Some of you struggle with health issues. And I personally think that's just the way it is. I think that's what life is like. In this world, we'll have tribulation, but be of good cheer, because I have overcome the world. And so we need to not just see our problems, but we need to see our solution, our Savior, Jesus, in all times. So if the ushers would come. Favorite part of the service for me is not the worship, it's taking your money. I'm just kidding. I don't see any of this money. It is part of our worship, though. It is part of our trusting God and saying, Lord, I trust you. And so let's give, and let's give generously. Lord Jesus, we thank you for your generous gifts to us, your lavish love, your endless mercy, your kindness. We thank you for your presence. So Lord, just bless your people as we seek to bless others. We trust you, Jesus, and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Go ahead and take the offering. And I was with the church last week. I know you're supposed to run the video, but give me a second. I was with the church last week, last Sunday. Great group of people, great kind of a Aeron Brown worship leader guy, but like twice as big, with red hair, and he was just a mountain of a man. And he danced around and sang, like he had a phenomenal voice.
Come on!
And it was just fun being with him. But when I got up to preach, I told him that it was really hard to do so. It was really hard to speak to them because I had building envy. They had been given their building. We're in this church. It's 42,000 square feet that they were given.
The good day.
So I said, told them, I told them in the kindest way I could that I hated them. And then we went from there. But it made me go, oh, you know, we need to pray that God would give us a building, you know, or someplace, something, right?
Yeah.
So we need to be praying for that because we're going to need that. And, you know, God's capable of doing that. God's capable of anything. Yeah. So we need to just all be praying into that and asking God to give us something. I told them I don't appreciate going to these churches. I go to, you know, churches a lot of times and, you know, somebody gave them a building. I'm just going, that's just not right, God. I have my lamentation moment with God, you know. And, but he always says it's going to be okay. So run the video.
Wow.
Say, how would you like to bless a deserving family this Christmas?
Who, me?
Yes, you.
Sure, what do I do?
Grab it.
Done.
Buy it.
One snuggie. Mom, what are the 3 digits on the back of your credit card? Done.
Wrap it.
Hey, little sis, how would you like to earn this shiny quarter?
Done. Now what?
Return it.
Done. If I can do it, so can you.
Pick up a gift tag off the Christmas tree in the church for you. No little sisters were actually bribed in the making of this film.
Cool. Daniel, good job, buddy. Daniel Cox is producing these. Good job. You know, we give about 16% or so of what we take in away in benevolence. And that's a very high percentage. And so I personally believe that's why we exist. We've been through a lot of trouble. We've had a lot of difficulty and a lot of trying times. But I believe that the generosity to the poor is really key to us being here and being able to do what we do today. So bless you for that. Now, more Aeron Brown.
Yeah.
Hopefully, buddy.
Just so thankful for you guys. I've been here so many times now. I think it's like 3 or 4, and I'm always impacted by you. Just thank you for just being the kind of church that you are. I've been in all kinds of churches and messes and good things and bad things, and I'm just refreshed by your worship to the Lord. Thank you for just being sincere in your devotion. It's beautiful to me.
I've never felt a love like this before. I've never felt a touch like this before. What can I do? Fall in love with you, Jesus. I've never like this before. I've never felt a touch like this before. What can I do but fall in love with you, Jesus?
Yeah.
What can I do but fall in love with you? Oh, what can I do but fall in love with you? Oh, what can I do but fall in love with you, Jesus?
Song, but I feel like I'm supposed to sing it in just the light of what Carl just spoke about.
last year I went through a lot of sickness, and I was felt a lot of brokenness, and all my friends around me, it was one of those seasons where all my friends were stripped away, not because they were angry at me, but just because it was time for their promotion, you know?
Wow.
And I had to begin to see it like that, but part of me was just like, ouch, you know? And I just kept singing this song through my health issues, and I want to thank you guys too. You guys prayed for me, and I'm like really, really good right now on my health, so thank you. Thanks for keep praying for me. It answers that. But songs like this just help me through it, and maybe we can sing it together. Get some ammunition. I think I've sung it before, but here we go.
Though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
There's a stronghold of your arms. There's
got my back. With all of heaven's armies, yeah.
I'd like all the people that were baptized to stand up. If they're still in there, some of the kids are gone. There you are. There you are. There you are.
Those of you around, just extend a hand to them. We're going to pray for them.
Come on, son.
Lord, we thank you for new life. We thank you for new life, Lord. We thank you for these young wives.
Yes, God.
That have given themselves to you, Lord. That they would be vessels, Lord, to carry your presence. Lord, that they would represent Jesus in a way that our generation hasn't. Lord, bless them. Be with them. Strengthen them, Lord. Thank you for their families. Thank you for the example in the families. So, Lord, be with them. Your blessing be upon them in Jesus' name. Amen.
You might have to utilize Ed here for a second, but I want to pray for Don and Eva as well. They were in a car accident yesterday, and they're pretty banged up, but their car is totaled. but they're okay. And so we're going to just pray that God would give them relief and provide for them. So,
do you know what to do?
Lord Jesus, we thank you for Don and Eva. Lord, we thank you for their service to you and the life of this church. Lord, we thank you that they're vessels that you use, Lord, for your purpose. And
Eva's directing the film right now. Wow. Lord, so just bless them. Heal them, Lord. Strengthen them. Break, you know, the bruises and the back, Don's back, Lord. Touch his back now in Jesus' name. Bring healing, Lord, in Jesus' name. And all the stuff that goes around this kind of thing, Lord, and the accident reports and insurance and all that, I pray, Lord, you pave the way. And that you be with them, even as we are with them. And so, Lord, we just pray the blessing and peace. We thank you for them in Jesus' name. And we're still not done. Let's all stand and you just take us out of here on a high note.
Let the king of my heart be the mountain where I run, the fountain I drink from.
Oh,
God is holding on. When the night is holding on, yes, God is holding on. See, you're good, 'cause you are good, good.
Join with me in my compassion for my people. Finally, all of you, live in harmony with one another. Be sympathetic, love as brothers and sisters. Be compassionate and humble. Do not repay evil with evil or insult with insult, but with blessing, because this is what you were called to, so that you may inherit a blessing as well. Amen. God bless.
She did see me. Well, I got to be on the stage and